The roar of the engine is still big at the Kentucky Speedway, but so is racing ahead to make it the ultimate fan experience.
We have a saying, you know, we won't be fan friendly, and we really mean it, and we're working diligently on that all the time. And now when the race fans come to the Kentucky Speedway, they know that we mean it, that we are fan friendly.
To back that up, the Speedway added hundreds of acres of parking over the past 2 years. That was sorely needed.
The traffic is being handled now properly. The state has assisted tremendously. So that's going to ease a little bit of everything that we're doing here. So that's great.
And that was the biggest issue, although other construction projects were completed, like additional seating and infield parking. Now that the big construction items are complete, the track can concentrate on other fan-friendly things.
More tram rides, more bus rides, improved concession issues, a lot more cooling stations, and all that kind of, you know, gingerbready kind of things that are going to make it better for fans.
Another more cosmetic change this year is the color green. Green paint was applied to the walls around the entire interior of the track.
There's no other track that's got green walls, and it's a salute for us. We're saluting our primary sponsor, Quaker State. That's a Quaker State green that's on those walls. So everybody, when they look at those walls, they're going to think about Quaker State, and they'll also be thinking about, hey, they're racing at Kentucky Speedway.
All that's left is to bring another winner to victory lane. Perhaps someone like the first two winners, Kyle Busch and Brad Keselowski.
Those drivers fit what we consider our profile to be. You know, they're young and up and coming and aggressive. And I think it's kind of ironic that those are the kind of drivers that have won our first two Quaker State 400s.
And like those drivers, the Speedway is ready for its third year of Sprint Cup racing.